Hello everyone, this is Professor Taramati Nakod from Government First Grade College, Kulgo. Welcome you back to Accounting Theory, Part 4 video. In this video, we are going to see Introduction to Accounting Environment. Now let us see what we are going to see in this. First, we are going to see Accounting Environment. So, Accounting practices are influenced by the changes in a socio-economic conditions. So, changes can be macro or microeconomic environment changes that will require changes in the users of accounting. So, to serve these people and changing needs of these people, accounting should also need to be changed. As you know, change is a law of nature. Always there is a change in the environment. So due to that, there will be changes in the accounting also. Now let us see what are the economic environmental changes. So economic growth will lead to development in a accounting field. So economic growth may be leading to the changes in the macro level or at a micro level. You can see after the introduction of LPG, there is change in the pattern of business, and due to changes in the business, now earlier we are going to do business at a domestic level, now we are doing it at an international level. Sitting at home, we are buying goods from other countries and we are selling goods to other countries. So the change has taken place and it is at a macro level as well as a micro level. When the environment changes, that will lead to change in accounting policy, accounting as well. Economic development leads to changes in the government accounting. So when economic growth takes place, then there is always change in the accounting as well as government accounting. So government planning, so now you can see 5 years plans are there, government budgets are there, taxation policy of the government are there. They are influenced by the changes in the economy. Now you can see due to pandemic, lot of changes in the government plans and budgets have taken place. You can even see in a GST when it was introduced, there are lot of changes in the plans, budgets and taxation policy. So when these changes take place, absolutely there is change in accounting practices as well. Now, socio-economic environment. Socio-economic environment deals with poverty, social security, ecology and host of many other sides of the society for which accounting measurement and reporting are warranted. This particular field is called as social accounting. This is also sometimes called as social responsibility accounting. Means business is there in a society and it has taken resources from the society and it is contributing to the society. Once it has taken resources from the society, we are liable to discharge our responsibility towards the society. Nowadays you can see so many people, they are donating lot of money for the people who are affected by this pandemic, and they are giving money to the government to control such a situation. So such a responsibility towards the society is called social responsibility accounting. Then when you are doing this, you are giving money to the society, taking benefit from the society, how it is to be shown in accounting, that part is called as social accounting. Corporate social accounting reporting considers the following point. So companies are also contributing towards the environment. They are taking resources, they are using resources, at the same time they are polluting the air, they are polluting the water. So there is a need to control such pollution. They are contributing towards the environmental safety. So this is a environmental protection. Then when you are doing production, you should use resources in an optimal way. You should not waste the natural resources. You have taken it from the society. Service contribution, provide service to the society. It may be free education, scholarships to the students, or it may be the hospitals. Okay, then community development, you can have parks, you can have libraries for the public. So these are the contribution which corporates are nowadays doing. Then human resource development, you can have some training programs to the students, you can give some online training. Nowadays people are giving online training so that the people, they get some skills and they earn their livelihood during this pandemic. So such a activity of corporates are called social responsibility accounting, and how it is to be reported is a social responsibility accounting. Legal and statutory environment. Whenever there is a change in the environment, always there is a change in accounting. So as I said earlier, now legal and statutory environment will also change. Now you can see there is an introduction of new Companies Act. When MRTP Act was introduced, FEMA was introduced, all these things have changed the total pattern of accounting. Earlier we used to keep the records in the horizontal form. Now we are doing it in a vertical format because of changes in the Companies Act. So whenever there is change in law and statutory environment, always there is change in accounting and reporting aspect. So these are the major environmental changes which have led to the change in accounting. So now you can see accounting in changing environment. As I said, it is not a separate activity. Accounting is depending on the environment. Whenever there is a change, there is a change in accounting. Change in environment, change in accounting and reporting. Accounting and reporting to external users. Now needs of external users are changing. Then whenever you see there is a international standards to be near to their standards, we are upgrading our national standards. So Indian standards are changing so that we can come near to the international accounting standards. So these are the things, because of that we need to change our reporting. Next, as we just explained social responsibility accounting towards the society, we should so show our responsibility towards the society and accounting for accountability for it. Change in gaps in response to changes. There are always changes in generally accepted accounting principles. As a response to that, always there is a change in accounting. With this, now we have completed the first unit of accounting theory. These are the references. Now we again say thank you once again.